time now for Sunday Brunch, and joining us this morning is Chef Luigi, chef and owner of Al Tiramisu Restaurant in D.C. Good morning.
Buongiorno, how are you?
I'm very well, and your buttons on your jacket woke me up this morning.
Yes, always al dente.
I thought they were real noodles at first. I love that.
Well, you can have it, but they have to cook a little bit.
That would be very al dente. Okay, Chef, what are we working on today?
Well, we're going to do friselle today, which I will explain later a little bit why they are and how they are made, etc. The history.
Okay.
It's working right now. Basically, this is like a dry bread, and what it takes is like when you need to use it, you put a little bit of water like I did, and you leave over there. So we start, we take this beautiful heirloom tomato.
Okay. And does the bread, has that been sitting out to dry it, or is that
no,
how it's
this
made?
Is actually, this, when you make it, it takes, basically, you can use it for a long time. It was an ancient way to preserve bread for when you use, remember the shepherd, they were going to the mountain, and then mm-hmm. they would stay there weeks, sometimes months. So whatever there was time to use them, to knead the bread, only they did, they put some water, and then of course whatever they had, and you were basically have your meal.
No preservatives then.
Oh no, because at that time they didn't have a refrigerator like we have today.
Right.
So obviously you can do a lot of things with it. So today what we choose is like a little bit of spring onions over here. They're fantastic. I love them.
Mm-hmm. And the heirloom tomatoes.
Yes.
How would you say the taste is different between an heirloom and just a regular tomato?
Oh, it's good. More juicy, more sweet,
sweeter.
More tender. So mm-hmm. you have to use it faster rather than the other one. They can last long, etc. So this is perfect for salad. Perfect, like, you know, mm-hmm. for use like we do today. We put a little bit of cucumber also, you know, like whatever. See, the farmer, whatever they were producing, whatever they had in the season, that's what they used to use for this. A little bit of fresh basil is always good.
And while you're cooking here, tell us a little bit about your restaurant. You're in Washington, D.C.
Yeah, we are on Tupan Circle, 2014. It's the most authentic Italian restaurant in D.C., I would say on the East Coast. Why not?
And as you're working, we're showing the address for the station. If you would like a copy of the recipe, you can write to us at 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. And this looks very simple, really. You could even do a high-end tailgate today.
And so what
do?
We'll put a little bit of mozzarella over there.
Oh, okay. Mm.
Boy, oh boy.
And then we put on...
I like the ability to use up dry
and is that going to soften the bread?
Yeah.